In this video, I will explain how to solve inverse kinematics for a single leg that has 3 degrees of freedom. Inverse kinematics is used to control the robot by finding angles at different joints, like this point, these points. To find the angles, we have to have 4 inputs. 2 of them are the lengths of leg components, which are L1 and L2, and they are also constants. And the 3rd input is the final coordinate of leg step in 3-dimensional space. And the 4th one is the coordinate at joint 1, or the root of the leg. The reason why I only focus on a single leg of a robot in this video is that finding the entire robot's inverse kinematics is much more difficult, but also that if we know inverse kinematics, or if we know how to solve inverse kinematics for a single leg, then we can solve for the entire body, because it's just a matter of rotating around the z-axis. Okay, let's start with by considering the top view diagram of this leg. And here we can see there's an offset from center point to joint 1. So because this offset will become inconvenient in our calculations, we start by removing the offset. And this is very simple to do, by just subtracting the coordinate of joint 1 from each joint, this point and this point. Once we remove the offset, we can find the first output, angle theta, using inverse tangent function. Now we are almost ready to analyze the side view of the diagram, but before that we have to create a new axis called P-axis, so that we can work on a 2D plane or ZP plane. And we can now find the distance between this J3 and Z-axis by using this formula from the angle we found before, and the X coordinate X, and then we can find P. Now we can start analyzing the side view to find theta 1 and theta 2. And from this diagram, that we can see that beta minus alpha is theta 1. So theta 1 is equal to beta minus alpha. And to find beta and alpha, it is convenient to find this length L using Pythagoras. Now we can find angle alpha using inverse sine function, and we can use cosine rule to find angle beta, and using those length constants and L that we just found in using this equation. And once we've got beta and alpha, we can solve for angle theta 1, which would be our second output. To find the final output, theta 2, we can start by finding the angle gamma using similar method to that we used to find angle beta. And once we found angle gamma, we can add alpha and gamma together to find the final output of theta 2. In this video, I explained how to find those 3 angles from 4 different inputs: the final position of the leg step, and the root of the leg, and 2 length constants. in the next and future videos, I'm planning to explain how to use 3D rotation matrix and the inverse kinematics equations that we found today to construct the entire body inverse kinematics. And I'm also planning to show how to implement inverse kinematics using Python and maybe MATLAB as well.